Jeff Slauson here from 19 News Now at the 19 News Digital Desk. In a few days, well, less than a week actually, a group of more than 40 members of, or advocates, excuse me, that are looking to get some research done for lung cancer will be heading down to D.C. The large part of this and the biggest effort that they are trying to front is trying to get more funding, trying to get encouraged research done, things like that. They believe, excuse me, that a large reason why we've been seeing as many lung cancer cases as we have is because a lack of access and a lack of funding. A lack of access and a lack of funding has been taking place for many people. So we spoke earlier today with an advocate based here in Cleveland who will be going down to the DC area to try and speak with some of these congresspeople to try and see what they can do, see if there's a chance, a potential, that they'll be able to provide more funding to help many who are living with lung cancer. Let's take a listen. If you don't mind, kind of start a little bit with what your what the plan is for you when you head down to D.C. into Washington.
Sure. So I'm really excited, first and foremost. I'm grateful for the opportunity to be able to continue my mom's legacy right through the American Lung Association and Lung Force. And so one of the big things that we're going to be focusing on is really, number one, healthcare ask, right? Because we tend to live in this world where healthcare gets a little complicated and things get a little crazy. But, you know, the big thing is really advocacy around, you know, better access for screening, right? I'm grateful that my mom was able to get the screening that she needed in order to locate the fact that she had lung cancer early enough where we were able to go through, chemo, radiation, all of those things. Because I feel like if we didn't do those necessary steps in the beginning, because my mom was against it, that my mom wouldn't have had this journey to share with people. And she continues through me. Obviously, she made her transition last year. So that's one of the big things we're doing next week when we'll be in D.C. is really advocating for the healthcare ask for, you know, obviously better screening and all those good things.
Why do you feel like it's needed to have a moment like this for you to be able to speak? I mean, why do you feel like it hasn't necessarily been accepted that more help is needed and more attention needs to be paid to these types of problems and to this problem in particular?
I think it's important, number one, because in our world that we live in, I think simplicity becomes complex. And what I mean by that is there's so many things that go into healthcare. And I think one of the biggest things is us maintaining our health when it comes to starting with screenings, right? How many people have walked into the doctor's office thinking, you know, a little itch is just a little a rash, but really it's something bigger, right? And I think we need to really preface that screenings, you know, following up with appointments, those all those things are important. And, you know, being a part of this journey is key for one, not just for other people who are caregivers who, like me, were once doing that for my mom, but also for people who are new on this journey, whether they're young or older. So I think it's truly important to really keep these things in the forefront to remind people that your health is your wealth, hands down.
We've had discussions just over the past couple of months here. For many people, this beginning of this year has not been easy. Many health benefits, things like that, that COVID-19 had protections over, have fallen away a little bit. And for many people, access to the proper things, whether that be screenings, whether that be just standard checkups, whether that be the comfort of being able to go to somebody, that seems to be at a low for a lot of people here. You spoke a little bit on your particular, at least, or you know, why you feel it's needed that you need to say this, but how difficult is it for people to feel comfortable to actually approach someone and say, hey, I want to get screened or I want to get looked at? I mean, that's a pretty intense thing. The average person, I feel like, has a hard time just going to the doctor in general, let alone for something that serious.
Well, I'll be honest, I think it takes a level of vulnerability. And in our society, vulnerability is looked at as a weakness instead of a strength, right? We've all been in this boat where we needed help, but because of what in our mind we think, oh my God, what's somebody gonna say if they learned that I went to the doctor for a checkup and it ended up being cancer? I think we have to learn to shift our mindset to learning that asking for help is true strength instead of a weakness. So I think when it comes to access to affordable healthcare, when it comes to access to screenings, I think we just need to ask the big question. asking for help and realizing that the answer is always no until you ask. So that's my biggest motto that I live for, Jeff.
You have a lot of people that think, oh, this would never be me. You know, I would never be one person that could cut out on this. You have a personal relationship to this here. I kind of want to go to that point. It can be anybody, right? I mean, it can be anybody in this situation here. So that's why people should be caring. That's why people should be paying attention to this, right?
100%. And my mom was one of those people who said, how could this happen to me? And my mom served in the military. She was an Army veteran. I mean, she taught for the school board for 13 years. Very active, always up and down, following me around, all those things. And of course, she gets diagnosed with stage 3 non-small cell lung cancer. She's like, what happened? How did this get missed? So it can happen to anybody, truthfully. It can, whether you're super healthy, whether you're, you know, getting back into the swing of a healthy lifestyle, it truly can. So us being open and realizing that it can happen. And just when it does happen, whether it's to you directly or to someone who's close to you, have an open mindset and be like, you know what? Okay, this happened. I'm on this new journey. What are we going to do to work from problem to solution?
You're heading down to D.C. with about 40 other people, I think, here. Having the opportunity to talk with like-minded people, having the opportunity to meet with people who have had family members or maybe are individuals that are living with lung cancer, what does that do for both you and for the mission that you're all on together?
I think, number one, it creates that sense of community, because when I was caregiving for my mom, I'll be honest, I felt alone. And my mom didn't want everybody to know about her journey. And so being able to connect with like-minded people, being able to continue her legacy and inspire other people to take their health into their hands and not continue to let it just go by the wayside. So I think that sense of community, because like they say, teamwork makes the dream work. And I'm a firm believer that we can all sing together, even if we can't all talk together. So it's that teamwork, that caregiving spirit, that we're going to make this work no matter what.
We're about a week out now from when you'll be heading down there. My last question is, when you leave, what are you hoping that you had accomplished, and what are you hoping that people know could be coming in the future following when you're down in the Capitol?
What I hope is, number one, that my story is heard. Other advocates who are coming, their story is actually heard and digested by Congress, that we are the real faces behind some of these challenges. Like, I'll be honest, my mom was someone who was oxygen bound, and one of her medications, and I will say this openly, cost over $30,000. And I'm grateful that we were able to be able to use Medicare and Medicaid to be able to afford it, for my mom to be able to have, you know, the life that she did until she made her transition. So number one, I want, you know, these faces of the advocates, myself and others, to be seen, to be heard, and to not just be a statistic and a number. And, you know, I would say for next year, I hope the turnout's bigger. You know, I would love to see this on a global scale where people are coming from all over the world to be a part of this movement and to continue to advocate for better screening, better access, and more health for everybody all around.
You answered all my Okay, so that is the did kick out a little bit early there, but that, so we have all of this information available on our website right now at cleveland19.com, the full list of how you can participate, how you can help, all of that listed right now on our website at cleveland19.com. We additionally will touch on this tonight on 19 News at 10 and 11. If you do turn on the CW right now, you'll catch the very end of our 7:30 newscast. A fair warning, though, for those that are going to be tuning in at 11 o'clock on CBS, we'll be on late today due to the March Madness tournament. We have a game that starts at 9:40, so expect us around midnight, around that time. All right, much more to come here, both digitally and on TV. For now, I'm Jeff Slauson with 19 News. Have a great night. Much more to come in the next couple of hours.
19 News, now streaming on Samsung Smart TV.